In this video, I want to briefly describe the impact on energy metabolism of diabetes mellitus. Before I do that, it's helpful to review the healthy response to high concentrations of glucose in the blood. In a healthy person, high blood glucose is sensed by the pancreas, which secretes insulin into the bloodstream. Insulin has numerous effects on energy metabolism. For one thing, insulin inhibits release of fatty acids from triacylglycerol in adipocytes. In fact, insulin stimulates synthesis of fatty acids from acetyl-CoA and storage of fatty acids as triacylglycerol. In the liver, insulin promotes uptake of glucose and its storage as glycogen. Oxidation of glucose to produce ATP is also favored, as is the pentose phosphate pathway, which promotes biosynthesis. In muscle cells, glycogen storage and glucose oxidation are also stimulated. Consumption of glucose in these pathways acts to decrease the level of glucose in the bloodstream. This is the healthy response to elevated blood glucose. There are two main types of diabetes mellitus. In type 1 diabetes, which is usually identified in childhood, the cells of the pancreas that produce insulin have been destroyed in an autoimmune response. Therefore, the person is unable to make insulin in response to high blood glucose levels. The pathways that are stimulated by insulin are not turned on, and in fact, the body behaves as if it is fasting. Fatty acids are released from triacylglycerol. In the liver, glycogen breakdown, gluconeogenesis, and ketone body production are favored. Glycogen breakdown also occurs in the muscle. High levels of ketone bodies in the blood cause the blood to become acidic. Glucose levels remain high in the blood, which can lead to complications such as undesirable glycosylation of proteins in the eye and nerve damage in extremities. Fortunately, type 1 diabetes can be controlled by regular insulin injections. Insulin is produced for medications using the kind of recombinant DNA technology techniques described elsewhere in this course. Type 2 diabetes typically arises later in life in a person whose insulin response was effective when they were younger. Why some people develop type 2 diabetes is not completely understood, but genetic factors likely play a role. Other risk factors include advanced age, being overweight, and having a sedentary lifestyle. In people with type 2 diabetes, the cells of the pancreas that produce insulin have impaired function and do not produce as much insulin as would be required for a full response to high blood glucose. Often, the cells of the person are not as sensitive to the presence of insulin, resulting in a reduced response to the insulin that is present. The impact on metabolism is similar to what is seen in type 1 diabetes. Triacylglycerol and glycogen breakdown are favored, as is gluconeogenesis and ketone body production. Treatment of type 2 diabetes often involves weight loss, exercise, reduction of carbohydrates in the diet, and medication. And this concludes the review of energy metabolism in the course.